Over the past few years, Celeste Barber's mug has been everywhere, on our Insta feeds, on stage, on mag covers, book covers, just bloody everywhere. And now her mug is the new mug of makeup brand MCO Beauty, and she joins us now to talk about it. Celeste, thanks very much for joining us. I mean, this was inevitable, wasn't it, that you'd become the face of a makeup brand given all the glamour shots that you've put up on Instagram?
Absolutely. It's the whole reason I started this whole thing, was to become the face of MCO Beauty.
Celeste, it says that this makeup brand is vegan. I didn't know animals wore makeup.
Yeah, I know, right? And, well, supposedly it's a big issue that people have pork or something in their mascara, but not MCO Beauty. It's vegan and it's also cruelty-free, which is good. And Australian, an Australian brand, which I'm very excited about.
You would get asked, I know you do, to be the face of so many things. Why have you said yes to this one?
Mainly because it is an Australian brand and it's accessible to people, because there's so much fancy stuff that's out there that is for fancy people, and that's great, but I kind of really want, you know, Tammy in Tamworth to be able to feel fancy, and while she's getting nappies at Woolies, she can also get excellent mascara, afford to get that, and afford to feed her kids that week and feel real fancy.
You're just like the rest of us, you know. We've all got 7.7 million Instagram followers, Celeste. People love you for your posts. I've got to ask you, though, about some of the videos I've seen. There is one that makes me laugh so much. It's of you on a beach putting up a tent, really, more than anything, mocking a lovely girl who's about to sit down on her beach chair. When people watch you when you're doing that, do you think they think you're filming an Instagram video, or do you think that's a mad woman that can't put up a tent?
Well, I think both. I think they think, oh, that's that mad woman who films those Instagram videos. But it has gotten to a point that model I'm parodying is Irina Shayk, and, you know, just looking amazing, putting up a chair. Now when I do videos, especially like on the beach and stuff, a woman came up to me the other day as I was about to do one, and she went, oh my God. And I went, no, it's weird, and it's going to be weird, and I need you to go away because I just need to do it. And she was like, you're full on, and left. So I did it, and then I was nice. But I find it quite confronting, and my husband just kind of takes it and runs. When we're in public.
Well, hot husband isn't just stuck behind the camera either. He has made a few little cameos on the feed. How does he feel about coming out in front of your 7+ million followers to do ridiculous dances and all sorts of things?
He feels fine. He's retired now. He's fine. You know what I mean? He's okay. He's an arborist.
He's retired now.
It's all right.
He's fine.
Yeah, I was like, you dance, queen, you'll be fine. It's fine. It's all fun. He's the guy, though, when I do a post with him in it and I post it out, he's the guy that goes through the comments. And I'm like, well, you're not that interested when it's just me, are you? It's just when it's him. So. But he's the greatest. He makes it all, you know, so fun, and yeah, he's a very good sport.
Would he consider coming out of retirement to perhaps parody one Tommy Little on this desk, who made his modelling debut a couple of years ago? And I think either you or Hot Husband could do a great job with these, because they are ridiculous.
They are full on. I mean, I thought photos of me went around a lot. I have seen these photos so many times. And I reckon my husband would do it, but yet I don't know if you could afford him. He's pretty full on about that now. You might have to.
How many times have you sent Celeste those pics?
Tommy?
It's a bit weird, mate.
I've been sending hard copies around to everybody.
Yeah. I reckon that's
all
got
the time.
To stop.
My husband's like, Tommy's sending me these photos again. Tommy keeps sending me these photos. Like, he's weird like that. Don't worry about it.
So a lot of the people that you end up sending up on Instagram, we've noticed, get in touch with you, like they appear in the comments to talk to you about it. Have you become friends with any of them?
Yeah, I've become friendly with some of them, which is nice. It's nice to be like, yeah, anyway, I was talking to Cindy Crawford and she said, like, that's a fun thing to say. Especially, you know, to people that were mean to me at school. I'm like, I've got a point to prove because I'm friends with Drew Barrymore. Sucked in. So that's always nice. It's always a real bad vendetta behind it. But, yeah, it's fun. They're nice and fancy.
Celeste, I feel like you're at this point where your account is so much bigger than a lot of these kind of influencers that you are parodying. Do you get a bunch of saddos who message you and go, can you please parody me?
Yep. Bunch. Heaps. I also get people going, oh my God, have you seen so and like big fancy people going, oh my God, have you seen so and so? You need to parody her. She needs the followers. And I was like, oh, yes, hey, it's full on.
Did that happen just before when we tried to convince you to get your husband to send up Tommy's photos?
Look.
Am I the
same? You said that, Waleed. I didn't. That was you. I didn't say that.
Celeste, always great fun to have you on the show. Thanks very much for speaking to us.
Thank you for coming to my house where I live. Sure. Thanks, guys.
What a great video, and we've got plenty more, so why not click the subscribe button here? Or is it here? Or is it... Sorry, I can't see the button. I'm not wearing my glasses. But you can see it, so... So you click on it to make sure you don't miss any more content.